Oh.
Is she dead?
No. No, she's breathing.
Now get a stretcher, then find the governor and let him know.
Right.
You were told to keep them under constant supervision.
I only turned my back for half a minute.
You know what this lot can do in half a minute.
Smith, I'm quite sure that you had something to do with this attack, so I'm sending you to solitary.
Oh, you can't do that. You've got no proof.
I don't need any proof.
That's not fair. She was only...
Thank you, Mrs. Jackson. Go on, Coulson. She's only trying to what? Had Eve threatened you before?
The governor spoke to you, Coulson.
You've been in a lot of trouble since you've come here, Coulson. Had you confided in us in the first place, Smith wouldn't be on her way to solitary. Eves wouldn't be unconscious. Now, you've got to learn to rely on the staff, not the prisoners. We run this place, not them. We're in charge here.
And you better get that straight, because you're going to be here a long time.
Antonio McNally died in hospital half an hour ago.
I can understand why you didn't want to say anything in the governor's office. I mightn't approve, but I can understand. In a place like this, there's pressure on everyone, and someone's always trying to make trouble. If you wanted to keep me informed, just unofficially, it certainly wouldn't do you any harm.
Until the others found out.
Now, how would they ever find out? Oh, well, suit yourself. It doesn't matter to me. We find out everything sooner or later anyway. Now, inside. And if you change your mind.
Oh, Vera, I've been looking for you.
Oh?
It's a bit difficult, really. We're having a meeting in the staff room in about 5 minutes.
What about?
Well, the staff are up in arms about the way Fletcher's been handling things. You're deputy governor, so I felt you should be told.
Thanks.
Now, it's a question of whether your allegiance is with Mr. Fletcher.
I'm a union member. I'll be at the meeting. Comes to that, Mr. Fletcher's probably a union member.
Oh, I'm afraid his presence might inhibit discussion.
Of course. And the situation certainly needs to be aired.
Well, see you in 5 minutes, then.
Oh, geez. There it goes again. Bell rings, out we go, just like bloody cows.
Mm. Who are you calling a bloody cow?
Oh, forget it. I said bloody cows.
Come on, you lot. Early closing tonight.
What's the big rush?
None of your business.
Well, we're going to get trampled in the rush.
Come on, just get going.
Oh. Excuse me, Mrs. Barry.
Yes, Birdsworth?
Where's Bea? Why didn't she come back?
Smith's been put in solitary.
Solitary?
Again?
Well, what's she done?
You know what she did.
They couldn't prove nothing. She was right here with us.
That's right.
Well, it's nothing to do with me.
But that's not fair.
What about the rules?
No rules have been broken. Now, look, it is nothing to do with me. Now, just get moving, the lot of you. Come on. Come on, Lizzie.
Smith's in solitary, and the rest are locked away for the night.
Good. Just a minute, Mrs. Jackson. I haven't finished yet. Seem to be in a bit of a hurry. There's something we better have out. Now, Smith bashed Eves. How did she get the chance? You were the supervising officer.
I told you I was discussing business with Officer Barry.
And you were so busy gossiping that not one, but two prisoners managed to leave without you noticing.
We were not gossiping.
Well, what was this business that was so absorbing?
Routine.
Come off it, Mrs. Jackson.
Eves was waiting for the chance. It took her 2 seconds.
Then Smith had to see what was happening, then go after her. Now, come on, Mrs. Jackson, what's going on?
You're not in the army now, Mr. Fletcher.
Mrs. Jackson, running this prison is a very difficult job. Now, you may not agree with everything that I've done, but then again, I doubt whether you agreed with everything that Mrs. Davidson did. But you gave her loyalty.
We were discussing a meeting of officers. There's a lot of concern amongst the staff about the way things are developing. We're meeting to talk about it.
When?
Now, as a matter of fact.
Now? Well, why wasn't I told? I'm a member of the union.
It's your administration we're discussing.
And I've got a right to put my point of view. Shall we go, Mrs. Jackson?
Well, I, for one, just don't agree with compulsory overtime. Oh, come on, I've got a family to look after. This job places enough strain on family life already, as I'm sure everyone here will agree. So I repeat, we need strong action. Added to that, there are problems on the job itself. All these new disciplinary measures. I mean, it's just building up resentment amongst the prisoners. Just walk through the place. You can feel it.
That's right.
And what's that going to lead to? Sooner or later, it's going to lead to violence. Violence against the officers. Now, to get this thing in order, I move we officially complain to the union. Have I got a seconder? Good.
Sorry I'm late.
Oh, come on in, Meg. We all agree we've got problems. Have you got anything to add?
No. We've got problems.
Now, what's all this about?
Mr. Fletcher was not invited to this meeting, Meg.
Mrs. Jackson didn't invite me. I'm a union member. I'm entitled to be here. Now, what's all this about?
It's about the serious situation in this prison. It's keeping us away from our homes and families.
And this new hard-line policy. We're concerned that inevitably it's going to lead to attacks on the officers.
Well, I'll tell you what I'm concerned with. I'm concerned with insubordination.
Nobody's been insubordinate, Mr. Fletcher. The staff have every right to hold a meeting. However, I think there's more to gain from discussion than confrontation. And that's why I believe Mr. Fletcher wanted to attend.
Mr. Fletcher?
Yes, that's right.
I think we should detail our problems and see what we can sort out.
Well, there's quite a list.
But it'll have to be done sometime.
I think Meg's right. What we want boils down to this. No compulsory overtime, an increase in staff, and the return of privileges to the prisoners.
And the cancellation of the Keep Fit program. It's upsetting the prisoners for no good reason.
Are you out of your minds?
Well, I don't think that's a very constructive attitude.
I'm acting governor here, and you want to cancel every change that I've made. Do you want the prisoners to think that I've got no authority at all? Do you really think that your lives are going to be made any easier if they think they can bully you lot into pressuring me?
Apart from which, there are practical problems. The number of staff is a matter for the department. I take it you'd be prepared, Mr. Fletcher, to make strong representations on our behalf.
Yes, of course.
I'm afraid we feel strongly on all the other points.
And I'm telling you, it's just not on.
Well, surely we can compromise. Staff unrest isn't going to help your standing with the department.
My standing with the department's got nothing to do with this, Mrs. Jackson. I'll do what I think is right.
We do have legitimate complaints, Mr. Fletcher.
Look, I realize that a prison can't function efficiently with the staff and administration at odds. Now, I'm prepared to cancel the Keep Fit program and the compulsory overtime. But the loss of privileges must remain.
Well, I think that should improve the situation.
And I insist on constant prisoner supervision, at least as far as the staff situation will allow.
Well, the loss of privileges isn't indefinite, obviously.
Well, they'll be reviewed after what I consider to be an appropriate interval.
Could I suggest we accept this situation, or the moment?
Yes, I'll go along with that.
Good. Maybe now we can get back to the business of running a prison.
I thought he might be starting to learn.
So did I, but the way he walked out, I'm not so sure.
You were very quiet, Vera.
Yes, between you two and Meg, well, things were pretty well covered. How do you think he'll react to us standing up to him?
Hard to tell.
Anyhow, we won most of what we wanted.
Oh, look, that's not the point. If he doesn't understand why we're upset, then it'll happen all over again. Oh, come on, it's all right for him sitting in that office writing memos and feeling self-important. We're the ones in the front line.
Anyhow, a man's not right for governor here.
I'm forced to agree with you.
Oh, well, see you tomorrow.
Bye.
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 Thanks. How do you think it went?
You were very good.
No, not that. Do you think there'll be any more trouble?
I wouldn't be surprised.
Mrs. Jackson.
Bye.
See you.
I wanted to thank you.
Well, what for?
Your good sense in there.
I hope you don't think I'm on your side.
No, not at all. But without you, things would have been a lot more difficult.
Well, I just hope things settle down now.
Believe me, Mrs. Jackson, if people just let me get on with my job, they will.
You're in early.
Yeah, it's the only way I can keep up with all the paperwork. I'm beginning to respect Erica Davidson more and more each day.
But not changing your ideas, I hope.
Oh, no. She's got her style, I've got mine. Her way is different, not better.
Anything special happening today?
Ah, yes. Two transfers from Barnhurst.
Farmhurst dumping their problems in our lap.
Well, Wentworth's dumped its share of problems in other people's laps. This woman, a Pat O'Connell. Now, she's been transferred so that she can see her children more often. Apparently, the request has come from the Prisoners Reform Group.
Oh, that bunch of interfering do-gooders.
Well, I think it's fair enough. A woman should be able to see her children.
Oh, nothing personal intended, Mr. Fletcher. I'd forgotten your family.
Nothing personal taken, Miss Bennett. Would you take care of these admissions for me, please?
If you wish.
Problems?
With the staffing situation as it is, I've enough to do in my capacity as Deputy Governor.
Well, get Mrs. Jackson to take care of it.
Have you read these?
No, I'll get around to it later.
This woman was here before. Caused problems. She's nothing that we can't handle, but Mrs. Jackson may have reservations.
Look, what are we running here, a prison or a kindergarten?
I couldn't agree more.
If Mrs. Jackson has reservations, she can see me about it.
When I finish with these files, I'll put them on your desk.
Fine, I'll get around to them then.
It stinks.
What?
Oh, you know.
That bee?
Yeah, it stinks. And I don't care who hears me say it.
Well, you would if Vera was around.
Oh, stinks. Putting a pound and nobody bothering to prove anything.
Yeah, well, it's all because of Fletch.
Now, that's enough.
Well, it is, Mrs. Jackson. So he lets us off his stupid exercises this morning. Big deal.
Yeah, and what about all the privileges he took off us?
Right, our TV and our radio, even our cards.
Well, if action's to be taken, it's because you've asked for it.
Wouldn't have happened if Mrs. Davidson had been here. You know that, Mrs. Jackson.
Go along, back to work.
I reckon we all ought to front up to him and march into his office.
Oh, we'd never get near it, Lizzie.
Oh, we've got to do something. I've missed 3 TV specials this week, and on Friday, John Wayne's on.
Why don't we write to the department and complain?
Oh, because, lovey, the screws wouldn't like that. They read all our letters and cut out the bits that they don't like.
They read our mail.
Both ways, in and out.
I thought all that stuff went out years ago.
Oh, screws never change. They've got their own TV sets and that's all they worry about. Even that one.
Don't you say a word against Mrs. Jackson. If they were all like her, we wouldn't be in this mess.
How's it going?
Well, if you can ignore the verbal flack, fine.
I'd soon shut them up.
Well, we haven't all got your special qualities, Vera.
You're to go to reception. A couple of new admissions.
You told me to watch this lot.
Governor's orders. I assume he knows what he's doing.
See that one over there? We call her vinegar tits.
What was that, Birdsworth?
Nothing, Miss Bennett. I just said I'm bored to bits.
Are here yet?
Just coming.
Where are the papers?
Over there.
Well, if it isn't dear old Meg Jackson.
Tell him what happened.
It was me. I killed your husband. But you're really glad to see me, eh?
That bastard.
Who?
What's wrong? Jim Fletcher. I've been set up. Here, you'll have to do the admissions. I'm sorry.
Meg, what's wrong? It's nice to know you're welcome.
I want a word with you. In the corridor, if you don't mind.
Governor's orders. Prisoners must be under constant surveillance.
What kind of a twisted joke do you think this is?
What joke?
Did you know that Chrissie Latham was coming back in here?
I pointed it out to the governor. He said we're running a prison, not a kindergarten.
He said what?
He said if you had reservations, you could see him. Look, he's still upset about last night's meeting.
To hell with last night's meeting!
Get back to work, all of you!
He specifically asked for me to admit those prisoners?
Yes.
Me, by name?
Yes, but I'm sure it's nothing malicious. He's just up to his ears in work.
Look, stop trying to defend him, Vera. I am not going to work in this prison while she's here. And I am going to tell him right now.
What's wrong with Mrs. Jackson?
Back to work, Birdsworth.
She looks upset.
It's none of your business.
She ain't in any trouble, is she?
Nothing like that. The one in trouble is someone else entirely.
What the hell do you think you're playing at?
I beg your pardon?
Setting me up like that.
I haven't the faintest idea what you're talking about.
Oh, don't give me that.
I'm not giving you anything, Mrs. Jackson, and I want to know why you've come bursting in here like a maniac.
Chrissie Latham.
Who's Chrissie Latham?
Oh, my God. What are you, a half-wit? The new prisoner. Do you know what she did?
I haven't the faintest idea, but I'm sure we can talk about it.
She murdered my husband.
I didn't know. Miss Bennett didn't tell me.
She said you flew at her when she brought it up. Aren't you supposed to be the governor? Didn't you read their files?
Yeah, well, I haven't had time.
Haven't had time? New prisoners. It's your job to make time.
Look, Mrs. Jackson, I'm terribly sorry that this has happened. Now, if you'd care to sit down, I'm sure that we can discuss it.
The only thing I wish to discuss is when you are shipping that woman out, because I am not working while she's here.
Look, Meg, we have...
Mrs. Jackson to you, Mr. Fletcher.
Mrs. Jackson, we have a severe staff shortage. Now, you know that. I can certainly arrange for a minimum of contact,
but that woman is transferred, I am not working here.
Well, there are procedures. They take time.
Mrs. Davidson would have gone straight to the department. That woman would not have been allowed through the gates. Now, I bailed you out of a hole last night, and I am not doing it again. This time, you can handle the job alone.
Look at her. She's sure pleased about something.
I've admitted the two new prisoners. The doctor's examining them now. Have you seen Meg?
She was here a few moments ago.
Upset? Vera, what's going on? Oh, what's Fletcher up to now?
Look, he's just inexperienced.
Inexperienced? Why is Meg so upset?
Chrissie Latham.
The new girl?
Before you came here, there was a riot. She killed Meg's husband. Look, Mr. Fletcher's under a lot of pressure at the moment.
All right, Vera. I can appreciate your loyalty. Did he assign Meg to admit her?
Look, when he's been in the job longer...
When he's been in the job longer, we won't have a prison. Oh, come on, Vera, that Latham woman should never have been admitted.
I know. What are you going to do about it?
Well, I'm sorry, but last night I thought we'd sorted a few things out. Obviously, we didn't. It's time to do something. You're acting deputy governor. If you want to stand down, we'll understand.
No, I'm a member of the
union. Oh, good. Right, now I'm going to talk to the others. We'll call a meeting. This time, Mr. Fletcher won't be there.
No sign of head lice?
Told you were wasting your time. Now, do I take my clothes off?
No, Chrissie, you don't.
Oh, you and me, Doc. We'd go really well together.
If you don't mind, I want to check your ears.
My ears? Oh, come on, Doc. I can do better than that.
Chrissie, I've had enough of this.
Well, I haven't done anything yet.
Miss Meadows, take her out of here, please.
But we haven't finished the examination.
We'll resume it later when you're not in such a playful mood.
Oh, well, anyway, plenty of time later, eh, Doc? Oh, Doctor.
Takes all sorts. Sit down, please. You're Pat O'Connell. You a trustee?
I want a parole. I want to be with my kids for Christmas.
How many kids have you got?
Two little ones and the older boy.
I see. What are you in for?
Aiding and abetting. My husband and the oldest boy, they're in an armed hold-up. They came home and I didn't turn them in.
Well, I suppose if that's the law, there are reasons.
Oh, sure, there are reasons for everything. Reasons for that and reasons for what I did.
Well, it shows the kind of man we're dealing with. Allowing that Latham woman back here and then detailing Meg to admit her.
If we don't take a stand, things are going to get worse. Right. Now, I suggest we resurrect all our demands and get the whole thing settled. Now, are you all in agreement?
Yes.
Good.
Sorry I'm late again.
It's all right, Meg. We're all agreed. It's time for drastic action.
Well, that's fine by me.
You feeling okay, Meg?
Sure. Vera not here?
No, but she said whatever we decide, she'll back us up. Why?
It's nothing. Well, what about the others?
Well, they're all in agreement. I've sussed out everyone on duty and those I could get on the phone. It's unanimous.
Okay. Well, what happens next?
Well, I've already been on the phone to the union. They agree it's disgusting, and they're ready to back us to the hilt. Anything we decide.
Then I move we strike.
Good. Well, it'll have to work this way. I'll present our demands to Fletcher. If he doesn't accept them, then it's everyone out. All those in favour?
All right.
Against? Carried.
What's going on?
Yeah, it's only the middle of the day.
Oh, come on, be a sport. If we're going to be locked up, we've got a right to know why.
It's probably been another murder.
Or else somebody's escaped.
Oh, come on, you've got to tell us.
Oh, yeah, come on.
Inside. Good day, Lizzie. You old bag.
Oh, Chrissie. Chrissie Latham.
Inside, Birdsworth. You too, Anderson.
Now, what's all this about?
We've several matters to take up on behalf of the union.
I thought we'd settled all that last night.
So did we. Events today proved otherwise.
You're referring to the matter concerning Mrs. Jackson.
That's right.
Well, I've already apologized to Mrs. Jackson.
I'm afraid things have gone beyond that, Mr. Fletcher.
We have been appointed to present you with a list of demands. The officers are tired of being the meat in this sandwich.
What demands?
The immediate transfer of Latham.
I'm working on that.
The end of the present constant surveillance, which is totally unnecessary and further alienates staff from prisoners. Reinstatement of privileges to the women. And the release of B. Smith from solitary to avoid further unrest.
Oh, you've finished, have you? I mean, you wouldn't like something else, like perhaps the crown jewels or maybe my head on a platter? This is unbelievable. That the staff of a prison should demand that criminals in their care, convicted criminals, be pampered and pandered to.
We are concerned with the safety and well-being of our fellow officers, nothing more.
I've been placed in charge of this prison to try and maintain harmony. Now, I made more concessions last night than I thought were justified, and I'm certainly not going to make any more.
If you don't, Mr. Fletcher, the staff have voted to strike. Well?
All right, you're on strike. I'll inform the department. They'll no doubt contact the union.
You'll be provided with a skeleton staff to maintain order. The women are locked in their cells.
Yeah. Miss Bennett, as Deputy Governor, might I inquire where you stand on this issue?
I'm a member of the union, so I'm bound by its decisions. But I'll be staying on duty as one of the skeleton staff.
Thanks a lot. Thanks for everything. What's going on?
We're on strike.
On strike? Over what?
A whole list of things, but the last straw was Chrissie Latham.
Yes, I was amazed they brought her back in.
And I refuse to work while she's here, and the staff have backed me up.
You look like you could do with a drink.
No, I don't think so.
Sure? Well, it must have been a hell of a shock seeing Chrissie again.
It was.
Well, then what I'd say is you need a drink with your local GP.
Save it for Karen.
Well, I don't think that was called for, Meg.
Don't you? Well, I'm sorry, I don't need your sympathy. Or want it any longer.
Let me out. Let me out. They're not allowed to do this. I'm only on remand.
Oh, come on.
But it's been hours. You can't do this. Get me out.
They can't, but they have. Come on. Come on, sit down.
Why?
There must be a strike. It's the only explanation.
A strike?
Oh, this is what happens when there's a strike. We're locked in till they settle it.
How long will that be?
Could be days.
Days?
Or could be. Or it might be just a couple of hours. But there's no use in getting upset.
You seem to know a lot about prisons.
I've been inside for a couple of years.
What did you do?
Hid my husband and son after an armed hold-up. Aiding and abetting.
What about you?
I killed somebody. Shot her. The woman who murdered my mother.
I read about that in the papers. You're,
Roslyn Coulson.
That's right. I'm Pat O'Connell. I'm pleased to meet you.
So, you didn't really do anything wrong?
That's a matter of opinion. Do you expect to be convicted?
I did it. But the woman that I shot, she was acquitted. And she was as guilty as anything.
It's sad. Someone as young as you. You know what I miss most? My children. They're growing up and I'm missing it. But I've made myself a promise. This Christmas, I'm going to be home. I'm going to be with them.
I'm glad we've been put in here together.
So am I. It's funny, isn't it? Our crimes are a bit the same in a way. Yours for your mother, mine for my son.
Where did you get that chocolate bar?
Out of the vegetable crisper.
I hid those.
Well, I found them.
Judy.
What?
They're not good for you or the baby. Oh,
for heaven's sake, you were the one that stopped me eating the pizzas and the fish and chips.
Well, I didn't mean for you to take over the whole chocolate industry.
Well, I like them.
You want a cup of coffee?
It's bad for you.
Can I talk to you for a minute? Look, I don't mean to nag. It's just that after being in prison, you have to sort of get used to, well, having to keep an eye on someone.
Yeah, Gran's the same.
That's another thing. This whole setup's a big strain for her.
I know.
What are you going to do for money once the baby comes?
Well, I've got my single mother's pension and the bit that Dad gives me on the quiet. And I'll get a job as soon as I can.
Could you move back with your parents?
You don't know my mother. She wanted me to have an abortion. And when I said I wouldn't, she said I'd be shaming the family and I'd be on my own. And she meant it.
Well, have you spoken to her recently?
Wouldn't do any good. She's a fanatic.
But it's her grandchild. I'm sure she'd change her mind.
She's just getting worse. Dad told me. Don't you think I'd try if I thought it would help? Do you think I like Gran having to work so hard?
Your mother sounds just like mine. Come on, let's have that coffee.
Yeah, Barnhurst was never dull. That's what you ought to have here. Men and women all in together.
All together?
Well, as good as. Of course, we weren't supposed to mix. But where there's a will...
Oh, I'd rather have a good bottle of whiskey.
Oh, we used to sneak on over there at night, me and a couple of the other girls, to the men's block. One of the screws would leave the gate open for us. We used to have parties.
What did the screw get for leaving the gate open?
Oh, what do you think?
Good. Man, to have to be hard up to have a woman with a laugh like that.
What do you mean?
You sound bloody dangerous.
Yeah, well, I'll tell you something. They were lining up at Barnhurst.
Oh, yeah, I bet they were.
Like I was saying, we used to have these parties. And this particular night, I got a bit full.
You could get grog in there.
Of course we did.
Oh.
Anyhow, this night, I decided to do a strip. So here I am, right in the middle of it, when the door opens and in walks the governor. You've never seen people move so fast. Under the beds, out the back door. One poor bloke, he tried to hide behind the stove and he nearly set himself on fire. But I didn't bat an eyelid. I just went right on stripping. And the governor, he sits right down, waits for me to finish, and then he takes me home with him.
Oh, that's all bull.
So you reckon it's all bull, do you, Dory?
Hey, leave her alone. Come on, if we've got to share a cell, we've got to get on together.
Yeah, well, if you want to share a cell with me, sweetheart, you're going to have to tone it right down now that Frankie's not here to protect you.
What's your mate like? That new girl. What's she like?
Pat O'Bloody Connell. She's a crawler. Sucks up to the screws all day.
Wonder when they're going to let us have some food. You hungry, Dor?
Yeah, a bit.
It's not right, keeping us locked up like this.
Wish Mrs. Davidson was here. It's bloody typical. Everybody runs out on us.
Mm. Yeah, what about some food? Bring me some food! Oh, God almighty.
You wanted to see me?
Yes.
Have you heard from the department?
They're negotiating with the union.
On what?
I don't know. And even if I did, I wouldn't tell you. You set me up, Vera. You deliberately didn't tell me about Mrs. Jackson.
When I mentioned the subject, you snapped my head off.
You'd have gotten through if you'd wanted to.
Checking the files of incoming prisoners is your job.
You knew how busy I was.
I thought surely you'd check the crimes and sentences. Now, was there anything else?
Have arrangements been made to feed the prisoners?
Of course. Dinner will be served in the cells. I'll be rounding up three of the trustees, Birdsworth, O'Connell and Flynn. They'll assist what staff we've got.
Well, that gets us through tonight.
And tomorrow?
Well, I'll stay locked in their cells until this matter's settled. The whole thing's out of my hands now, Vera. And yours.
I'll get the dinner started.
I trusted you, Vera.
I trusted you too, Jim. So I guess we're quits. Come on, dinner. Birdsworth.
Here, Miss Bennett. God, have I been sweating on this.
We have a special privilege for you, Birdsworth.
What's that, Miss Bennett?
Yeah, Vera, what's going on? What are we locked up for?
Do you want to eat tonight, Latham? That's better. Birdsworth, because you're such a model prisoner, you're going to be allowed to help serve the others their dinner.
When am I going to get mine?
After everyone else.
Oh, God, Miss Bennett, I'm starving hungry. Couldn't I have mine first?
Get moving.
Oh, couldn't I have just a little bit?
What do you know? Oh. Smells all right for prison chow.
Won't be for long, Lizzie.
On your way.
Oh. Hey, Miss Bennett, how much longer are we going to be locked up like this?
You feeling uncomfortable, Anderson?
Well, we shouldn't ought to be locked up like this.
You're being treated according to proper procedure, Anderson. It so happens that the officers are on strike. And the way things are looking, you could be in here for days.
Yes?
Mrs. Watkins.
Yes.
Can I come in? It's rather personal.
Personal?
Yes, it's about Judy. Judith-Anne.
If Judith-Anne sent you, she should know better.
She didn't send me. She doesn't know I'm here. She could use your help.
Really? Judith-Anne made her own decisions about life quite some time ago. I tried to give her advice, but as usual, she knew best.
She is your daughter, Mrs. Watkins.
Well, if I were dead, she'd have to get by on her own. I'm sorry, I don't discuss family matters with strangers.
Your mother, Mrs. Brooks, is very ill. She's in hospital, did you know?
Who are you?
My name's Karen Travers. I'm looking after Judy while Mum's in hospital.
Mrs. Brooks. And what's the matter with her?
She's very run down.
Oh, well, I warned her. I warned both of them.
Couldn't you at least go and see her?
Certainly. When I have the time now, thank you for letting me know.
Mum, Mrs. Brooks, and Judith-Anne really would like you to be friends. You see, Judy's problems have given Mum something to live for. Otherwise, she might still be in prison.
You seem to know rather a lot about my family.
I was at Wentworth with your mother.
I see. So you're a prisoner too. I should have known.
I'm on parole. I wouldn't worry, Mrs. Watkins. Some of Australia's finest families have convict backgrounds.
Well, well, about bloody time.
Give it to her. And I wouldn't try anything, Smith.
What's going on? Who's this?
I'm Pat O'Connell.
O'Connell, speak when you're spoken to.
Oh, don't panic, Vera. I've got too much on you to blow it.
But I've got a right to know when I'm being let out of here.
That's a matter for the governor.
It's not, you know. You can't keep me in the pound for longer than 2 days without the direction of a VJ.
O'Connell outside.
Oh, got yourself a puppy dog, have you? Well, what's going on?
What you don't know can't hurt you, Smith.
You've got 2 days.
You've forgotten something. Mr. Fletcher's running the prison now, and Mr. Fletcher does things his way.
How are you, Karen?
Sit down.
You're working late.
Oh, I haven't stopped all day.
I don't know what they'd do without you.
They'd find somebody else.
I've been busy too.
Good.
I went to see Judith Ann's mother.
Uh-huh.
Well, it wasn't the easiest job in the world. Judy warned me it would be difficult, but I... Is anything wrong?
No. Why?
You don't seem all that interested.
Oh, I'm sorry. Of course I'm interested.
Is it because I made such a fool of myself the last time I was here?
You didn't make a fool of yourself. We're friends. Now, tell me about Judy's mum. I'm all ears.
Well, she seems to totally reject anything that's not within her scheme of things, but I did manage to get her to go and see Mum Brooks in hospital.
Good girl. That's excellent. Look, I've got some letters here. Do you mind if I open them as we talk?
No, sure. How is the PRG?
Oh, it's making some headway. I've managed to get Pat O'Connell transferred from Barnhurst so she can see her kids.
Good.
Oh, this is the sort of thing that's depressing. It's from Major Linwood at the Salvation Army. He's from the missing persons section. He sends me lists of names from time to time.
Yes, that's right. I remember him. Do you ever know any of them?
Twice, in about 4 years. And in both cases, they dropped out of sight again. Oh, six names. I don't know any of them.
Who are they?
Snowy Kulwalski, George John Adams. There's someone here called Porky Hindwood. Ethel Payton, Doreen May Anderson, Tom Robinson.
Doreen May Anderson. Any details?
Last heard of in 1959 in Flemington, being looked after by her father. Her mother's trying to trace her.
Certainly sounds like her.
That's 20 years ago. She could have got married, changed her name by now.
No, I'm sure it's her. Angela Doreen Anderson's in Wentworth.
No, the trouble with people is that there's not enough of them that sat down and really thought what life's all about. You ever done that, Doreen?
Yeah, all the time.
Doesn't pay to think too much. Gets you into too much strife.
I mean, what is life about? It's easy. Living. Getting the most out of everything. So why do people disapprove of me going with the fellas?
There's something here you ought to read, Chrissie. It says, how to have a lasting relationship.
Who wants a lasting relationship?
Me, that's who.
Well, it does you no good. People. Once they stake a claim on you, they stop taking an interest. No, I reckon if you can get them competing, you know? Get 3 or 4 of them going, fighting over you. Know what I mean?
I reckon just one would be nice.
Good morning. They don't usually have the police here. Can I get in?
Sorry, madam.
What do you mean, sorry, madam?
You can't. There's a strike on.
A strike?
The officers.
But I need to get in.
I'm afraid you'll have to make special arrangements, madam, with the acting governor.
Well, could you please let me in so I could make arrangements with the acting governor?
Sorry, madam.
Constable, your manners are wonderful, but your PR leaves a lot to be desired.
Madam, the fact is he isn't in yet. I believe he was here very late last night. Ah, here's the gentleman in question.
What's his name?
Mr. Fletcher, I believe.
Mr. Fletcher, could I see you for a moment? My name's Angela Jeffries from the Prison Reform Group. You've got a new prisoner in there, Pat O'Connell. I'm sorry to get you at such a bad time, but her children are in my car. They know she arrived yesterday and they want to see her. So can I have a couple of minutes?
No, I'm terribly sorry, ma'am.
Pat O'Connell is completely trustworthy and her children need her.
No, I'm afraid it's out of the question at the moment.
I'll guarantee any conditions. I'm a lawyer, so I do understand.
No, I'm sorry, ma'am. Please, I'm very busy.
Mr. Fletcher, it would take a prison officer 5 minutes. I know it could be done.
Look, ma'am, I've got a strike on my hands. I've had 4 hours sleep last night, and I'm very busy. Now, perhaps when this is over, eh?
You
Yes, that sounds like a lovely idea. Right, Ellen, I'll pick you up in about an hour. Bye. Oh, good morning, Angela. Come in.
Thank you.
I was just getting ready to go out.
I won't keep you long. Did you realize there was a strike on at Wentworth? The officers?
No, I didn't. I can't imagine how they've kept it out of the press. Full marks to Mr. Fletcher.
From what I've seen of Mr. Fletcher this morning, he's more likely to be the cause of the strike. I just took some kids out there to see their mother, and he wouldn't let me through the front gates.
Well, with a strike in the place, I'm not surprised.
But security's not a problem. The women are all locked in their cells. I'm sure you would have organized it.
What I would have done is irrelevant. I've decided to resign.
Oh, no. Your sympathetic approach is just what's needed out there.
My sympathetic approach, as you call it, achieved nothing. Mr. Fletcher has a different approach. I'm sure his will be far more successful.
Well, he's not going to help the prisoners by bullying them and refusing children the right to see their mother. He obviously doesn't give a damn.
Was there anything else?
Oh, I'm sorry. Yes, there was something. Doreen Anderson. I've just had a letter from the Salvation Army. Her mother's trying to trace her.
Doreen!
I thought you'd be pleased.
Oh, she's been let down by just about everyone. She dotes on her mother. If she were to be let down this time, I'd dread to think what would happen.
On the other hand, if her mother does care for her, it's exactly what she needs.
I agree the attitude of the mother should be ascertained.
Well, I would do it myself, but I'm so snowed under with work at the moment.
Would you like me to do it?
Would you?
Yes, if you like.
Thank you. I've got the letter here from Major Linwood. The telephone number's inside.
Oh, I wish I could get out of here. Wish I was like you. You don't seem to mind.
Oh, I do. What's the point?
Wonder what's happening to Bea.
Bea?
She's asleep there. She's in the pound now.
Oh, I met her last night, delivering the meals.
Oh, you did? How was she?
Oh, she's fine. She's wondering what's going on. Miss Bennett wouldn't let me tell her.
That's Miss Bennett. The woman that I shot, she had a friend in here. A big lady named Martha. She attacked me out in the corridor. B hit her. Nobody saw anything, but they still lock B in the pound.
She'll be out soon.
How do you know?
Oh, they can't keep her in for more than 2 days without a VJ's order. And if nobody saw...
2 days? Oh, that means she's due for release today.
Things seem to be running remarkably smoothly.
I've always said we make an excellent team.
Smith's due out today.
I think we should leave her there till the VJ arrives.
What about the regulations?
There's a strike, isn't there? In circumstances like this, there are bound to be problems. Besides, that's one of the strike demands. It'll look as if you're caving in.
You never give up, do you, Vera? You'll kindly release Smith as per the regulations.
Maybe that's right. Maybe you are caving in.
Hello, Mum. Lorraine. What are you doing here?
Oh, I bought you some flowers.
How did you know I was here?
Girl that's looking after Judith-Anne.
Karen?
Yes. She came to see me. Well, I'm sorry you're in hospital. I did offer you a home.
Grudgingly.
Oh, you're just getting cranky in your old... as you're getting older.
Maybe.
Anyway, you didn't accept it.
And lead a lie. Pretend I'd never been to prison.
Look, there are some things the whole world doesn't have to know about. Still, if you change your mind, I'm getting too old to cope. There's a room there any time you want it.
It'd have to include Judith-Anne and the baby. That big house, you have the space, and she is your daughter.
Look, Judith-Anne made her own decisions. Anyway, she's always been impossible to control, all those fights and arguments. Well, she'd have the whole house in an uproar, and it's not fair on Ron.
He'd love to see her back, he told me.
He's always been a soft touch. You know that as well as I do. But his own health hasn't been the best. You can't disrupt the whole household for the sake of one person.
But what about the baby?
Well, I'm prepared to help it financially.
If your daughter's not good enough to live in your house, I'm sure she wouldn't want your money. And I don't either. Your money or your room.
Well, I'm sorry you feel that way, Mum.
So am I.
Maybe it wasn't such a good idea to come here after all. I'll get the sister to fix the flowers.
Time.
Outside.
If you're going to lock someone up in the pound for no reason, you could at least make sure they're fed and let out on time. What's up with this place?
There's a strike.
I figured that had to be it.
But I still wouldn't try anything if I were you.
You know, I reckon if Fletch keeps up this record, he won't even be here when Mrs. Davidson gets back.
You could be right for once.
It's true, she's agreeing with me. I think I'll change my mind.
There's only one problem, Smith. Mrs. Davidson won't be coming back.
She's resigned. And with Mr. Fletcher out of the race, guess who's next in line for the governor's job?